Hello folks, Clyde Lindsay here from Pixel Pro Displays. Thank you for joining us today in this Tips and Tricks video. Today folks, this video is on xLights, and what we're going to talk about today is the addition, or actually the deletion, of the settings menu that used to be in xLights. Now today we're using the version 2020.4, which was just released today, February 1st, and what's really exciting is that the settings menu was fantastic. I used a lot of settings in there. However, it was very frustrating and challenging to use. And one of the things that I want to do today is I'd like to give a huge shout out to Dan Culp for taking the time to go through and rebuild and set up new menus for us to use, as opposed to the old settings dropdown. We're going to have a few new interactive boxes that we're going to jump into that are very interesting and well laid out that will make it a little easier for us to do some things. But first, before we get into that, this video is brought to you today by the PPD Sequence Club. When you join the PPD Sequence Club, not only do you get one awesome sequence each and every month, sequenced by the PPD professional sequencers, you also get access to huge discounts and huge savings in the PPD sequence store, as well as across many different holiday vendors such as Boscoyo Studios. We have Ricky from CCL Controllers, Jadiation Controller Building Solutions. We have other sequencers, or actually members of the affiliate group. So come on over to PPD. pixelprodisplays.com and check out the PPD Sequence Club. It's a ridiculously low price for one awesome sequence each and every month. When you join the club, you get access to additional presets, effects as well. You get four every month. And so there's a lot of nice little benefits. So come on over, check it out. And with that, we're going to go ahead and get started. So everybody, whenever you first come in here, and I actually, and I'm going to admit this, there's another video that I recorded earlier today, and it was on the Queen Mary Van plugins. And I went to do the normal thing to teach how to install the Queen Mary Van plugins, and I went to the settings menu, and it's not there. And I realized that they had finally implemented the new settings menu. And to find the new settings menu, well, I'm just going to go ahead and create a new animation real quick. Nothing fancy, just a real quick start. And we're going to go in, and where the settings menu used to be was here, but now it's tucked in and nestled under the file menu. And we actually have two different menus. We have a sequence settings menu, and we have a preferences settings. So we'll go with the sequence settings menu first. And what this is this is the physical sequence settings menu that we used to have at the very top. Whenever you opened up the settings menu, whenever you clicked on settings menu, it had settings at the top. That was our first option, and this is the dialog box that would pop open. Now, this can always be accessed by clicking this icon right here, this little nutcracker and cog setting or icon. Whenever you click on it, that would bring up your sequence settings. So now this hasn't changed any, but it has been separated out from the rest of the menu. So it's easily able to be found just by clicking on this icon, which has always been a wonderful addition. Now, if we go back into here, we can see we have a preferences menu. And the preferences menu is now what you might consider the entire settings dropdown with regards to not including the sequence settings, which are found here and in the other box or in the drop down. So let's go through these, and now I'm not going to explain what everything is here. I've done a number of videos on some of these, but since they've changed, I may have to re-educate and relearn how everything's set up here in the new preferences menu. So first tab, we have our backup, and I have it set to backup on launch. I actually don't need to backup on launch. To backup your sequences, there's a simple way to do it under the file menu. You just click F10. I think it's F10. Pretty sure it is. Then the next tab we have is our view tab. This is how you preview things, probably in the sequence window. You have the tool icon size. We can change it to medium, or we can change it to large, or we can change it to extra large. I actually keep mine on large. I do like them that way. Let's see. I keep double clicking here. There we go. That's good. Version, auto detect, open GL sequence settings. So the OpenGL settings, that's your video or graphics. This is helpful whenever you're if you're having trouble displaying video output or just output just in general. I don't want to get into the details, but OpenGL setting, render order is another thing. If your render order doesn't seem to work right, or if your render doesn't seem to appear correctly, you can change the order and have different options here to make your render look a little better on the screen for you. Model handle size. So that's in the 3D section, I believe. Actually, I believe it is. You can change your model handle size selection. You can change it from normal to large to extra large. So if you have trouble seeing in the 3D layout screen, that's what that's for. You have effects assist window. That's auto toggle. That means whenever you put down the morph effect, I can't do it whenever this is open, it'll auto toggle. I actually don't like auto toggle. I like it always off. And there is a icon right here that turns the effects assist window. So that's a couple options there. So these are views. Show play controls on your house preview. So if you open up your house preview real big, you can have the house preview show on there. Play show controls. And then the auto show button, if you want this to auto show and just remove itself whenever it's not playing. There's effects grids. These are some of the effects and settings and so forth. This really would deserve its whole entire own video on what all these effects settings do, or not effect settings, but settings do. But just so you're aware, a lot of those sequence settings, if you are looking for them, this is now where they're found. We have a bunch of, there's no new options that I'm aware of. However, they are organized so that they're not in that long list of menus. And for many of us who have been sequencing for, using xLights now 7 years, 8 years, and version 4 came out, which is the version we're using now, version 4, this is something new for us. So it's going to be a little bit of taking it, getting used to for us as well. So again, this is really my first look. I just wanted to click. So here's random effects. This is a random effect generator. You can set what you want, whenever you want a specific effect to be included in the random or not. You have the color tab, which this used to be the color settings under settings, and this is really nice. This is a great function. I've done a video on this. And we have the email address. So I actually didn't put my email address in here yet. You can put your email address, so whenever you're packaging up sequences and so forth, to whenever you have a crash in xLights and it creates a debugging report, you can send it in and it'll have your email address attached to it if you place it in here. So with that being said, folks, I'll just click OK there. With that being said, that is the new preferences panel, and it's located here underneath the file menu. It's something for you to check out. Go and learn and check it out and see how much, hopefully it's a little easier and faster to find things, or it's a little bit more logical. But for sure, it's going to be something that's going to take me just a little bit of time to get used to having in the location that it's at. So again, folks, thank you for joining us today. If you like the video, please hit the like button, hit the subscribe button if you haven't done yet so as well, and don't forget the bell for notifications for all of our new videos when we do post them up on YouTube. And finally, we have an awesome family community on Facebook, and it is called Pixel Pro University. You can find it by going to Facebook and typing PPU Facebook group, or PPU or Pixel Pro University, and we have a great community where we help people learn and do fun things, and we usually have a lot of prizes and giveaways and do something cool every month, and we try to enjoy ourselves and have a lot of fun while we teach people things about the xLights and the RGB hobby in general. So thank you for joining us today, folks. This is Clyde Lindsay signing off from Pixel Pro Displays. We'll see you in the next video.